so many people warning me that this is a scam. And just to reset, I got a letter from a woman in Tampa, and she's a third-party tracer, and she says, please be assured this letter is not a scam. Provided you have not received payment concerning this claim refund, you're entitled to receive $237.50 from the U.S. government, and only if at one time you occupied and or retained title to the property located at, and this is where I used to live back in 1999 to 2000. I mean, she has got the address right. There's a check made payable only to you and sent directly to your home address, and she sent this letter to where I live now, so she knew where I used to live. She's got where I live now. And she says this money's been available to me since June of 2001.
Wow.
It's in a special fund, mortgage fund, and it's not earning any interest. She says she gets a processing fee when I receive my refund check, and that's where everybody's jumping in. Kirk, it's a scam.
So she said
a check, it'll bounce.
She's saying, I will mail you a check for, you know, $237, and you give me $23. So she's asking for 10%. I'm curious if she asked for 10% for everything. This is a big scam to run for $23 if it's not real. If it is a scam, $23 is sort of the lowest level you could, you know.
Right.
It's a lot of work.
And people said that I could go on and look at unclaimed property, unclaimed money, and I did do that. In fact, in one of them, verified. It's still looking. Completed results.
So, yeah, because we were curious, well, can't you do this on your own? What is she? How does she have the authority to find people's money for them?
Right.
You know, isn't that something we could all do?
Somebody said, a couple of people said that it's legitimate.
A guy called and said, I know all about scams, but he didn't seem to understand. He didn't seem to explain to us what, if you get a check and you cash it, how is that a scam? There's no way they can get your information. However, it could be a bad check and you're going to be stuck with fees, but that doesn't mean that other person benefits in any way. It's just sort of a ha-ha. You got feed.
A texter said, if that woman actually found you money that you otherwise would have never found, I'd still send her $23.
Okay, that's legit. That's a good thought, right? So getting a letter in the mail that says, this is not a scam, is kind of like starting a conversation off with your significant other. I didn't cheat on you. But let me tell you what happened last night. Like, it's kind of, okay, then why did you bring it up? Somebody, James, who called earlier, the check bounces and you, so to reset, Kirk got a letter that said, this is not a scam. You have money that's been unclaimed for
20 years.
And I'll give you the check. I've got access to it. You just give me a processing fee, a finder's fee, if you will, of 10%, which is $23. And we're trying to figure out how, if this is a scam, how is this person going to benefit other than getting $23, which seems minimal?
Look, her card right here says she's accredited by the Better Business Bureau, Marianne.
Which could also look up.
And you could also just print up cards and just put BBB right up on there.
Yeah. All right, real quick, let's get Steve from the Eastern Shore. Hi.
So, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Actually been going on for a while, man.
Oh, sorry, Steve. Can you start again? We got you now.
Sorry. This kind of scam has been going on for a while, and I think somebody else said, it's all public record. Like, I can look up and see where somebody was living at a certain time and where they're at now.
Yeah.
Now, they'll send you the check. You go to the bank, you cash it. By the time they figure out it's fake, they've already got their money. So you say she does 10 people, it's $230. It's $100. That's $2,300. You know what I mean? So
yeah, Steve, let me stop you here. Kirk is not going to pay her unless the check clears.
Well, see, and that's where it falls. Like, most people get the check, go cash it, and then they'll pay.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, not everybody uses common sense like Kirk's going to use, but... And that's how they do it. Like, they can do thousands of people in, say, a month.
Man, is that a lot of work?
And the return on that, you know, could be in the thousands.
Okay.
Hey, if they get one that doesn't work here and there, they don't lose anything because they'll never find them.
Right.
Hey, will you represent me in a court of law?
Yeah, man, come on. Come on to the Eastern Shore.
There you go.
Yeah, but Steve, remember, it said on the letter, this is not a scam, so...
It's not a scam. Oh, said it right up front.
Thanks, Steve.
I can write with a red pen and say it's blue.
Yeah.
Exactly. Nigerian prince. If it says it's not a scam,
I don't know why I'm not able to hang up. Well, I tried. Let's see. Oh, I like this one because Debbie says it's legit. Let's hear it. Debbie?
Yes, how are you?
Hi. Tell us
Debbie.
Why it's legit.
Hi. Well, there are companies that do that. It's, there are companies that could be fraudulent, but there's companies that do that all the time for a nominal fee, generally 10%.
I don't see the scam anymore. You cash the check, it goes through, you give the lady the $23.
Debbie, you're the last word, Debbie. If you're me, do you do it?
I would, but you can go on to HUD.gov and check for yourself.
Right.
And just to verify it. So, you know, I would probably do it for check first. And for 10%, it's worth it. And plus, she let you know about it you didn't know before.
That's true. That's true, money. He would have never understood that he had. Thank you, Debbie.
Debbie.
All right, we're going to listen to Debbie. Take the cash.